So I added the yeast to the flour and the salt, and then I add the malt powder. The malt powder gives the malty flavor of the bagels. And last thing I added was the water. The flour used is a high gluten flour because we want it to have a really stiff structure. Turn the mixer on, let it start to bring all of those ingredients together, and after about 8 minutes of kneading, this is what we have. We have a dough that has really great structure, and it's time to divide it. We have to portion it or divide it into 12 equal bagels because we want to make one dozen. So I use the bench scraper to cut it into fours initially, and then each of those four I cut into three so that I have 12 equal sized balls. We have to let them rest so that the gluten will relax, and then they'll stretch out really, really nicely. The gluten has to relax. Once you stretch them out, you can shape the bagel by putting the two ends together. You roll it a little bit so that you know that they've stuck together nicely, and you put it on the baking sheet. Once all 12 are ready, we let them rise in the refrigerator overnight. In the morning, some boiling water with some baking soda. This is what makes a New York style bagel a New York style bagel. It gives it the chewy texture. We boil them for about 60 seconds, take them out, and when I put them into my oven, I use a baking steel. It's just a quarter inch piece of steel that gives them the most amazing crust on the bottom. Temperature in the oven was 450, and after about 50